All right. This is, I'm at the other farm. This is, where we have our cows. I actually cut hay in the back of this place back here. We're actually going to try to bale today. Overcast. Probably going to be later when we get ready to bale it. But this is a, our calf creep area. These are old gates that won't swing anymore, obviously, half rotten. This is all relatively cheap. This is just stuff we had laying around the farm from other jobs. The gate was, it needs to be replaced. It's just wired up there, which I will replace it eventually, but works pretty good as a creep gate right now. I just took a sawzall and cut it. Calves come in here and eat. And if they want, they can come out here and pasture on this side. Or they can pasture on that side. But I was watching Larson Valley Farms, and he was talking about not putting too much money into your operation when you're getting started to make money. Because that's the name of the game, is to make some money doing it. Even though you do enjoy it, that's what we're supposed to do. This is just kind of our little setup. I encourage you to go watch his videos. It's great. I like it. But, like these little troughs, they're not much, but they work. Whenever we just grind some feed and kind of limit feed them. Just grind shell corn. You don't even have to do that, but that's just what we do. And these are railroad ties, used, as you can tell. There was not, this used to be, all it is, we went back in the woods over here and found some dead cedar trees that were, all the white had rotted off of them, and we just squared up one side with a chainsaw and put some boards on it and put them in here. That's all we did. And it worked for a while until it started leaning and the cows got to pushing it out. So we came in here and put these in here and concreted them. But this is our chute. It'll hold about two cows. And we just slide a pipe in the back so they can't back up. This, we applied for a grant and got this free and another one. Some things you just run across. It's pretty cheap anyway, but it works. And these were off the feedway. Whenever the barn blew down, knocked some of the feedway out, broke a couple of them. We just kept them and put them in here for this. But it all works. We get all the cows in here. It's pretty tight in here, but we get all the cows in, and we can work them all. Of course, once you get them on this side, you can't really do much with them because they're out on pasture. So, I thought the video that he put up about building the barn on the cheap, very informative. So, if you're getting started farming, cattle farming, I encourage you to watch it. It's pretty good. I'm pretty fortunate because my dad had some cattle, and I moved away from the farm and was a mechanic, and I didn't really care for that a whole lot. So now here I am back on the farm. When I moved back to the farm, he didn't have but about 25 cows. So that was before the cattle price went sky high. So we found some heifers pretty cheap, bought a bunch of them, and we just so happened the cattle price went pretty high for a couple of years, and we had just got lucky, really. It doesn't normally do that. Actually, I don't think it's ever done it like that. But we just took that money and reinvested into the cows. Into the facility. That's why we have this. And That's not much, but hey, you gotta make some money, so farming is work. It's not all easy. But anyway, I'm gonna make two videos a day, and the other one is gonna be try to get some of the hay baling and all that kind of stuff. So thanks for watching.